Autodesk Fusion Manage is our cloud-based enterprise PLM solution. Because it's cloud-based, it gets regular, progressive rollout updates, bringing important, useful functionality for your teams. Here are a few key highlights. We've added the ability to search and find classes while in the classification dialog box. This will greatly reduce the time spent properly classifying an item for companies that have extensive classification lists. You can now drag and drop images into the image fields on item details. There's also a new setting to hide trailing zeros on BOM quantity under Administration, System Configuration, General Settings. For tenants that contain items that were created before classification existed, you will now see a notification advising that a default class was assigned to the workspace and have the option to change as necessary. We've improved the way you can manage workspace view filters. Now, when the filter editor opens, all existing filters in the workspace view will be displayed, allowing users to quickly view, update, or delete existing filters in a consolidated way. We're introducing a new release in place feature, allowing organizations to deactivate the released version of a revision controlled item without incrementing version number or release letter. Deactivation is achieved through change control. If needed, the item may be activated again. Deactivating and activating the item in this case implies no change in form, fit, and function of the item. You can find this setting under Administration, System Configuration, General Settings on Tenants, set to use Modern UI. This setting is disabled by default. You can now conveniently save and access frequently utilized menu items through the new menu item bookmarking feature. More fields from the Relationships tab are now available in Workspace Views and Reports for users of Modern UI. Modern UI users can also take advantage of the new Actions Notification tab to create and manage the email notification sent out when a workflow action occurs. For more information on the full contents of this release, please refer to the Autodesk Help Center.